Today, I want to talk about the brand new AI planner by Morgan. I want to explore whether it's worth it, whether it's worth your time, whether it is a really powerful tool. We're going to explore it all in today's video. And also a bonus, because I get to sit down with the founder of Morgan and talk everything of what they're working on. So welcome. My name is Francesco. If you don't know me, we cover software for tools. For tools? No, we cover software for work and life, a way for you to find the best tools. So if you're interested in diving into more tools like this, you can jump into toolfinder.com. If you're interested. So a couple of weeks ago, I was lucky enough to sit down with David, who is the founder of Morgan. I do this occasionally. I occasionally blunder and actually call the CEO of Trello the CEO of Evernote. And I actually didn't make a mistake in this interview with David, which rare for me. But as you can imagine, we got to talk about all the future of Morgan. Now that video will be available to you below if you're interested. That's just a sort of fireside chat, raw one, that if you're interested in Morgan or in general, you can dive into. Now, a few weeks ago, I was playing around with this new AI feature, and I quite liked a lot of the things it did. Now, I want to talk today about how it works a little bit, because today is the launch date for it, and also about what they have planned for it in the future. I've played around with it, and it's pretty neat. I can't show you it, but it's pretty neat. So, the AI planner is quite an interesting one. It works off something called frames and tuning. So, let's start with the frames bit. Basically, you can set periods of time in your calendar which are dedicated to a type of task or a type of activity that you typically do. For example, if you're somebody that wakes up and between 9 when you drop the kids off at school and 10:30 you want to write, you want to get that content out, maybe that's like me, then this essentially allows you to block those times using smart frames, which helps you to essentially assign a certain type of task, and it will dynamically update, which means that, for example, if you're planning a week ahead and that is what you want the whole week to look like, or maybe Monday, Wednesday or Thursday, whatever it may be, then you can set it up as a schedule for the whole week so that it automatically populates with tasks like that, which is a great additional ability and what maps to something that I like to call the Benta methodology, a system for your energy workflow. We have a separate course on that and everything like that, but the concept of it is fairly simple. The process is where you're trying to adapt your workflow to your quality of your tasks for you. So for example, if you know that you have high energy in the morning, do high energy tasks. If you know that you have low energy in the afternoon, hit the low energy tasks, but it's key to be able to understand how you work and then adapt to that. And there's another ability called tuning in it, which is almost like the guided planning ability, where you can add breaks and buffer time to help align that and plan also a certain window of time ahead. So this, in a way, reshapes your calendar to being a dynamic calendar. You know, you typically look at your calendar and go, I know what I'm doing, and if I need to change it, I will change it. I will go in and administrate it. Whereas this administrates it for you because the calendar is just dynamic. It's like, whoa, it adapts to what you best prioritize or the attributes are best prioritized. So it's like a planner, but like a prioritizer in a way, sort of a fine-tuned middle ground. And they also have the ability to do this with tools as well. So if somebody assigns you some work in Notion, Linear, or any of the other apps that they connect with, it essentially dynamically updates. Now, I initially really liked this concept because it really aligns to how I would recommend people work, more to the pace of which you are happy with in terms of promoting higher quality work versus quantity-based work, because you can get sucked into quantity any day of the week. So I really like this additional feature. Obviously, I had access to it a couple of weeks ago. I originally made a video on the separate channel which we have about this, and I was very impressed. And largely, this concept is quite a nice sort of blend between what I had developed with the Benta methodology and how we sort of evolved it with a software, weirdly. But strangely enough, I tried another feature with David, and it's called a voice assistant. Now, I actually can't show you it because I don't think they finished it, but they gave me early access to play around with it, and I was quite impressed. In terms of the ability of being able to communicate with your to-do list application, this is something I've been dying for in a to-do list app for a while. Now, whether it's actually useful and functional in a daily routine, because people work so differently, like, for example, some people work at home and have the ability to talk out loud, or maybe on the mobile on the go. But whether it's actually functional is a different thing. But I wanted to definitely see this in the planner, and I played around with it. I was pretty impressed with how it works. So I was impressed largely this AI release in terms of what an app can actually do for somebody in the long run. And I think it's definitely a great step forward in terms of what it can actually do for you. Now, I think that what you can do in terms of the view doing abilities and management of your tasks is actually really good in Morgan, something I think they should lean more into. But the actually ability to bring in stuff that's automated is going to be a huge time saver. So today's video overviewed the release of AI Planner, an interesting perspective, something that is probably a bit more premium, designed for busy professionals, but an interesting perspective as we continually evolve in this productivity administration cull, which eventually will happen. We will not organize our own tasks, our own calendar, our own things for us. AI will do it for us. It just makes sense. And this is an interesting step for that. So thank you very much for tuning in today. I will finish my cup of tea. And while I'm drinking my cup of tea, head over to toolfinder.co to explore more. Thanks very much. And I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.